Hello everybody, a very warm welcome to all my Ikebana family. I'm Neena Varma, President of Delhi Ikebana International. On behalf of Delhi Ikebana International, I welcome all of you here today for giving us your precious time. We are very honored to have today with us Madam Shizake Suzuki. Madam Suzuki, apart from having a very pleasing and a pleasant personality, is also a keen Ikebanist. She's been a great sense of support and strength to us and our organization, for which we are very grateful. She is the Madam Chikaze Suzuki, is the wife of the Ambassador of Japan to India. And we are very happy to have her today with us. I'd also like to take up this opportunity to thank all of you who have been putting and sharing with us your beautiful arrangements. You've not only proved that you are ambassadors of hope and goodwill and positivity, but you've also shown that you're just like your flowers, no matter your space, restricted or large, no matter the occasion, happy or sad, you will spread happiness throughout the world. Delhi Ikebana International, in its endeavor to bring you the very best that Ikebana has to offer, is very pleased to present to you today Okyo Rekha Reddy, First Master O'Hara School. She is not only an experienced and a senior O'Hara teacher, she is an author to various books on Ikebana and has headed various Ikebana organizations. Today she would be doing her arrangements in the O'Hara School. Those of you who are new to Ikebana, Ikebana has various schools that teaches you different styles of arranging flowers, and O'Hara is one of them. Within the O'Hara school, you tend to imitate nature, represent it just the way as you see it. That's why you see a lot of landscapes, water features, and greens. Today, Rekha ji would be using all natural materials, either grown at her farm or given to her through her friends, to portray her version of nature. Come, let's view nature through her eyes. Over to Rekha Reddy.
Namaskaram. It's such a pleasure to be here this morning. Thank you, Neena, Varma, Shyama Balbir, II Delhi chapter and team for having me on this session today. I am grateful to Mrs. Chigaze Suzuki for being able to view this, and Mrs. Niho Okawara, the II International President, is here already or probably is joining in. Thank you to all the special guests, the senior masters, Ikebana friends, and of course, all those who are viewing for this morning and being there. It is a little strange because I'm not used to looking at a computer and imagining there are people there. It's like I'm only talking to myself. So it'll take me a while if I look uncomfortable. But I'm going to start basically with the seven kinds of arrangements. And before I start, I must pay my obeisance and pranam to my Ikebana teacher, Grandmaster Hori Meenananth Narayan, and my mother, Shyamala Maya Reddy, who are the ones who introduced me and taught me Ikebana, apart from various other teachers and nature, of course, which I've learned from. So with pranam to Lord Ganesha, we'll start the morning. And just to start off, so a little cup of tea for you to perk you up in case you're sleepy, tired. I just cut this from the garden in the morning. So a little cup of tea in a cup and saucer. So nobody can say that I don't have container, we can't do flower arrangement. So have your cup of tea so you won't nod off during the demonstration. Thank you. The first arrangement I'm going to do today is based on the circular form. So here I have a container. Now, why I specifically call this Lokebana today is all the material is from home or garden, and none of it is bought, of course. And I think 90% of the material is what I have at home. And there are about, I think I got some banana flowers and some asparagus from a friend this morning, two or three of my friends who sent in this. What the first arrangement I'm going to do, O'Hara School is almost a maybe 120 years old. And it's the one that innovated Moribana, the arrangements in flat containers. So like other schools of Ikebana, it starts with the headmaster and their child, son or daughter taking over. And it was innovated by Mr. Unshin Ohara in the late 1800s. And right now, the year motto is Mr. Hiroki Ohara, who's a young but very forward-looking headmaster. And we call him the rock star Iyamoto because of his little, he's so young and his little hairstyle and his young version. So everybody innovates a certain kind of Ikebana. I'm going to keep to a few basics and a few freestyle also. So the first one is called a circular form. And this is Lokebana. So I'm trying to use not only regular Ikebana ones, but what people might find at home. Like this is just a kind of a metal tray, like a flower, you know, like this, which was one of the wedding, you know, they give you sweets and things during the wedding. It's one of those trays. In that tray, what I put is this, is the palm inflorescence, just rolled into a little. So, and I'm not going to put in much water because I'm going to be moving it out later. So this is a circle of the palm inflorescence around it. And in this, I'm going to do a circular form. I'm going to put a base of green. This is called the Mawaru. It's an advanced Hanamisho. And we have, you can do this material going clockwise or anti-clockwise. So if I have asparagus flowing out, it has a nice line and a nice flow. I'm going to put my asparagus base on this, flowing around like that. They're very beautiful lines and curves. So this forms a connection. It's a more modern kind of arrangement compared to the bunjins and the rimpas, and I mean the earlier landscapes. It's a much more modern arrangement. The advanced Hanaisho has a circular, radial, and one row. So this is the circular form. And because I call it Lokebana, the reason, one is using the natural material. Secondly, people are stuck in lockdown period somewhere else, don't have a pin holder. Now this one doesn't use a pin holder. I'm just putting it in this without the help of a pin holder because this circular palm space form the kind of a holder for it. So this is my base of green. I have done a bit of pre-preparing to save us time as we are showing you the arrangements. So a little circular motion. And along with this, what I'll be using, can you give me the big one first, please? And is the heliconia. And these heliconias are my flower material. They all flow out. You can have them all in the clockwise direction or the anti-clockwise direction. Just float low. So you can put them on a, you know, you can put them on a center table or a dining table or any wherever you need to see arrangements from all around. So we have like a subject, then a secondary following it, and they're staying well without a pin holder because these are forming a kind of a grid into which I'm getting the flowers to hold. I have a circular flow. It is a low and kind of a circle like that. This is really taking some getting used to doing it, looking at the computer. See, once I'm on this, I can't hear anyone telling me we can't hear or this happened, that happened. No feedback right away. So I'm just hoping everything is going well and you can see well too. So we have good organizers and a good technical person helping. So I don't think we should have any issues. lovely touch of orange. These are from the garden, and they've bloomed. So many things were suddenly in bloom, little odds and ends, like they were made specifically, you know, for this. So I have about 2, 3, 4. I'm going to put maybe an odd number of flowers, because odd number is always good for our ikebana. And one more, so there's 7 flowers totally. And I have something interesting here. It's a kind of a cactus, and it's called, like, doesn't have a very nice name, the devil's bone or something, the common name, but very, very interesting. It has a little flower also, and they stay out of water also for quite some time. So this is going to be a little light connecting link between the three areas, giving it a little interest because of the lines of this material and the little flower that it has. All this is material that lasts really well. And for the last little material, I have the Himalayas. These are the Himalaya. And this Himalaya is going to be a little filler. I've made a tiny bunches of these. Some small, some big. That gives a little touch of color. Himalaya patterns. So a little touch of color there. So in today's arrangement, I have decided the theme is actually, they're going to be berries, pods, seeds. Every arrangement has some sort of a berry or a pod or a seed in it also, because this is a season when the main flowering is over and they're all forming into little, pretty little buds. So this one has the palm inflorescence and the berries of the palm inflorescence in it. I have 5 bunches of fillers. This one. And I have a little scroll here constantly of people joining. When they join, I can't see the arrangement actually. But okay, I suppose it is clear for you. I can't really make out. So this, ladies, is a circular form arrangement. And it can be actually viewed from all sides. See a little dance. I don't want to make you dizzy, but you can see this from all areas. You have your subject, secondary, and object all going in a circular fashion, but it's almost 2.5 feet wide so that you see it a little better. Okay. Thank you. I'll move on to my second arrangement. I'll have to move it this side. Let me see if I move it here. You can, if it doesn't come in the way, I'm going to put that there. So let's see. I'll do the second one now. So the second one I'll be doing is radial form. And my cutter, please, in the radial form. And the radial form also is an advanced HANA issue. You can do the radial form in a flat container, or you can do it even in a tall container also. So I'm going to use a tall container. I have a ceramic vase. This one, the first one was just a metal vase painted a flower-shaped one. This is a ceramic vase from Pondicherry. They make very nice containers in Pondicherry. So this is there. And I'm going to use, again, we have the theme of berries, of course. So the berries in this are the karonda. They're called the vakkaya or karissa. So I took almost an hour trimming this yesterday. So I'm doing all the trimming earlier so that you see more arrangements and enjoy it more than actually the trimming part. So I have these branches. So you see which side, I think this looks better on this side. I have water filled in this. See, this is like a subject area which goes in. This is better. Flowing in once. It's going a little high, so I can give it a, see how you twist. Put your thumbs under, twist the thing so that it comes in a little. Oh, I don't like that. Stays better. It has a nice angle, so I don't need a crossbar. Otherwise, I would have had to use a crossbar. That's my subject area in the end, going up like that. This is going to be my secondary area, a thick stem. These are very nice when you make chutney. You can make a sweet and sour chutney and it tastes quite yummy actually. So in a radial form, you have like a subject, a secondary, and an object. Earlier, the object used to be placed in the center, standing almost half or one-third. But the new, in the new curriculum, they have the subject a little lower. These bend down 60 to 90 degrees, and the object is about a third and bends down 45 to 60 degrees. So this is, in the earlier it used to be like, you know, taller and standing up upright. So the new curriculum, they say, just comes in a little bit lower. So I'm going to cut it at an angle, give it our favorite a little tick, and push it through so it just stays easier. If necessary, we'll shorten the stick. See, about there. So that is in the center. We can, that's the object. We can have another one. We have another branch. I've trimmed off most of the leaves. We, along with that. Gives a bit of filling there, and if these are too close, then maybe I'm going to trim off it. You don't want them. They are very beautiful branches and very strong also, you know, to put that. Now this is two materials. The third material I'm going to use a palm leaf. It's, I think, the Raffis palm. Just a little touch. I remember my teacher, Meena aunt, used to say, when you start doing arrangements or you want to do instructor, you have to do it from behind. And all in the class used to think of, how strange is she? We can't even do it from the front, and what are she talking about doing it from behind? So it needs a little practice, but then it just, it's nice. It gives you your brain a little bit of work in trying to imagine what it's like from the front. Another pale green one, just for a little bit of a background. This is not really going to be shown much, the front leaf, but a little slight light background like that. There's an angle there. I hope you can see that. Here I move out so you see the lines and the angles. So this is like a radial form where you have your subject, secondary, and object radiating out on both sides, like you have the sun's rays. So that's why we say a radial form. And you don't see the lip of the vase, so I move it a little at an angle like that. So we're all getting used to lockdown times in a very strange situation. I hope it gets over with it soon. So hopefully with Lokibana, you'll have a little more stress relieved. You should be able to do in whatever containers that you have. You should be able to do without pin holders. So that's the main reason I've done Lokibana, using material available in the garden. If you don't have pin holders, you can use without pin holders with these little ways I told you. Or you can just use containers that you have at home. They needn't necessarily be Ikebana containers. Nothing like having beautiful Japanese containers, but then in case you don't have. Okay, so we've done with our second one, which is a radial form. Again, berries in this also. And the third one I'm going to do is, it's called a Hanamai. And Hanamai means dancing flowers. It was innovated by Mr. Natsuki Ohara, the headmaster. who is unfortunately no more. So for this, I'm using a typical Panama-shaped vase which has slanting sides. And I just chose pale blue because it's just nice to have different colors. You used gray, gold color, and pale blue. So this has just about maybe two, sometimes one, two, or three material going out from different spots and kind of touching each other, meeting, touching, interlacing very gently. So like there are two flowers or two leaves or two materials dancing. So it's a little stark. So you have to, you know, get used to that. When you see that, you'll start appreciating the beauty of line. So usually Hanamai can be done in one container, two containers, or a maximum of three containers. So in this, I'm going to use, I have a heliconia leaf and I have a branch of the beautiful Tabubia mauve and jacarandas, which I couldn't decide which one to use. They have the Legostromia in the small ones and they have the large ones in the tree. See, it has a beautiful curve. So in a Hanamai, you can kind of see, like, you know, am I going to do it this way? Which way it looks the best, or this one here and this one here. So the line, or maybe like, you know, just kind of flowing over, flowing this way also is nice. So let me try this. I've cleared out a lot of the leaves from here. So that's a nice line. It's a beautiful curve that way. Then I have this leaf and this is like how they just come close together, meet, and then kind of move away. I can even have it flow over like that. Like it's kind of giving it shade, like, you know, like this. But the lengths I see are more or less the same. So I think I need to trim this a little bit. You need some difference in the length. Though there are two lines and the lines might seem simple enough, it does take some time to think and look at the best possible version of it. And support stick, in case it's not standing firm, a little support stick is always a good option. And with this, this way, or maybe just giving a little shade and a shadow like that. That's the Hanamai. And for the never. This is a basic Hanamai. You can have a touch of the flower if necessary. It will touch of it at the base. It can be on the other side. A little touch like that. I can put in the berries because each thing has a berry. I can put in berries. I want to show you the various options we have. So this is a dry brinjal, lady's finger, the okra pods. So this also can be a main line instead of the leaf. Instead of the leaf, you can even have this as a main line. See, just showing off the pods. So there's so much choice and so much option. Perfect for Lokebana. You have just two things in your garden and you can do a Hanamai. Like that. So I'm putting in a few of the pods here. So you have the Legostromia, the pods also there shown. And how you have, just for your choices of putting in more material also of the mauve. Several options. It's just even with two or three materials, it'll be spoiled for choice because there's so many variations. After all, we're imitating nature. And in nature, there is absolutely no end to what nature and God create. So if you're doing Ikebana, I think you'll go quite berserk trying to see what materials you need and need not use also. So this is the Hanamai arrangement. So you always used to wonder when the masters do it, how they fix it, and when you move it also, it doesn't move too much. So this is a good practice for that. The next one I'm going to do is in a basket. It's lovely to use baskets in Ikebana. In the O'Hara school, we do use baskets actually. Sometimes the light airy ones more in summer. So this is a good use of baskets. There. Okay. Okay, just a second, please. So my special in this is what I'm going to use is, some of you might have seen this. This is called Aristolochia or the Dutchman's Pipe. And they're in bloom now. It's not a very pretty looking creeper, but these flowers are very unusual and they're kind of amazing. They hang down from the branch like that. So this is what is I'm going to try and show off. And this also has to have a berry in it. So it's beautiful to use nature. We use so much of nature and landscape in O'Hara school. Every school of Ikebana is beautiful. There is no doubt about it. Every school is of floral form. So everything has its specialties of what would be good and not good. What I'm going to use here is the Aristolochia branch. The same thing, the Dutchman's pipe, it's a creeper. But if you notice, it has a berry. See, that's the berry. It's like a parachute. It's like an overturned parachute. Very, very interesting. This is how the berry comes on, the seed. And the seeds are inside this like a container. This is like a container. And it's the overturned parachute, and then all the seeds are inside that. It's really something very interesting and very unusual. So I thought, let me make use of this. So I want to give the importance to the berry. It's kind of a basket arrangement, but really more. Okay, well, I'm going to show off that. And I have, see the Aristolochia that come onto it like this. So let's have one flowing down. So you see, so that's the important part of this whole arrangement. I just have one of the Aristolochia bending there. I hope you see that clear. And now we have a beautiful choice. My garden has been very cooperative. Though I have more of greenery, but there's been some unusual material blooming. So when Nina said, why don't you do, Shama Nina said, do a demonstration anytime. So I thought maybe in August, but when I saw all these little things blooming, I said, let me do that quickly so that, you know, everyone gets to see it also. And in this, I want to put a flower material. I'm sure all of you in Delhi have beautiful, so you know, Delhi, the weather is good. You have such lovely gardens. And the last time I came, I think Kanta's garden cut so much material. Shama, your garden. So I told Nina, first, I want one of your gardens here if you want me to do an arrangement. But then actually, if you look around, we will find things to do. And it's been wonderful doing demos for the Delhi chapter twice earlier. Now it's going to be virtual. I said, my garden has been kind today. And there is a little bit of unusual material. This is the trumpet flower. I don't know if it's called the trumpet flower. It blooms mostly growing like that. It's almost the size of my face, if you can see it. They're huge. And they're not very cooperative. Cut them, put them in the vase, they don't stay more than a day. But it was looking so big and bright. I said, I really had to use that. So just one. Your concentration. And we have that one of the Dutchman's pipe out there for you. No, see, this is in mine, so it has to be on this side. And then another leaf, which you could use just for option. See, this is the Quisqualis indica, the Rangoon creeper. That also will be a good choice. There's so much you can use. Anything will look pretty in it. We can have a little, you know, a touch of the brown. A tiny touch of the brown. It's a dry palm leaf also in one area. That's the third material, forming a bit of a backdrop for the beautiful pink. Very. Maybe here. Of this. This is just a freestyle arrangement in a basket again, but mainly to show off the Dutchman's pipe and the lovely trumpet flowers. This is something I'm so excited about, but you shouldn't miss this. I've never seen this kind of a seed earlier, which is like a little parachute. You know, you should. I wouldn't mind jumping off my terrace trying to use this thing. It's so cute, and it has all these little seeds in that. So this is the basket arrangement, and we'll move on to the next one. This, you'll have to hold these together. So I have about three more arrangements. Should I? I'm just going to check to see if there's anything important I'm missing out on. I'm going to look into chats, Nina, in case there's something you need me to, anything you need me to do different. If I don't see a message, I'll go on. I'm learning all this. I think you've given me a chance to learn all this now. You can hear me. There's no message. That means we're all okay. Now the next one we're going to do, it's so interesting when you do demonstrations now. For the first time, I see the advantage of doing the demonstration at home. I can use so many containers, those which normally I'm scared to carry out because they're so obnoxious or so heavy, but I'm able to use all those things and, you know, do it nicely at home. The only thing you miss is the challenge. When you travel to do demos, sometimes I land a day earlier, maybe 2 days earlier, and in that 24 hours you're planning an entire exhibition. You no idea what containers you're going to use, what material. Very challenging and very interesting for the mind. So the next one I'm going to use again berry. Like I told you, there's going to be berry pod in everything that I'm going to. So berry pod seed day. So this is again from the royal palm, the berries, a beautiful red color. I'm going to leave a little container under it to hold material. You can't see the tip. Okay, there. So this one I'm actually going to maybe base it on, though it's a freestyle, it will be based on an inclining form. We always, even when we do freestyles, automatically you base it on one of the basic styles. So these are the ones which kind of fell off, so you can always drop them in there and remove them. It's more red and colorful. So in this, it's Lochabana again. You might not get flowers at all. You might not get vases. Use a cup and saucer. Use one of those metal trays, like I told you. You don't have kensans. You can do it without kensans, like you've seen in the first arrangement. You don't have flowers. You can do just foliage and berries. So this one will have only flowers, only foliage, no flowers at all. So this one, you have a flow. So I'm kind of in my mind basing it on a inclining form. So the inclining form also has a subject flowing down. It has an object which is about a third of the height and coming out in front. I'm using a colorful croton for this. So it's a beautiful material. So I had gifts from three of my friends suddenly. One sent leaf, one sent a banana flower, and one sent a little cactus. They're saying, if you want to use it, so I'm using all three. So you can manage perfectly without flowers also. You just use different colored foliage. It looks very, very pretty. So this is going to be like an object. In the front. So just the spot of color. Actually, even just the red and this with the yellow and gold, yellow and green also looks really nice. Even with this, you can add more. So this is just a freestyle, just the berries and this. I can make this like a, because I'm basing it in inclining form, I can do this. I can do one more standing up firm like a tall filler that you say usually. Fresh cut. So forgive me, all the cuts have to be made underwater, but today I'm not, it's beautiful weather for me. It's been raining constantly for 2 days. They've been in deep water, but the correct way is, of course, putting it and doing it underwater, the cut. So this is something tall there. A little flow out to the other side also. It looks a little bit of material flowing out to one side. This can be it, and if I'd like to, I can use two, this one more leaf like this. And it's, and we can use small leaves. I use just this sort of bird of paradise to put three material. It has a little red line in the center, so it kind of goes with this little red berries. So maybe I can use that in between. Look the same height, so I shorten this. And one little one coming out maybe along with this. Just connecting the berries with the rest of the arrangement flowing out like that. So this, now I'm going to move out so it's much clearer for you. It's a freestyle arrangement, berries again, because the whole, today all the arrangements are based on berries and pods. So we have berries, we have the croton, and we have the bird of paradise leaves, the ones with a little reddish pink touch line in the center, so they kind of match this really well. This will be a little difficult to move out. Just give me a minute. I think the advantage of online demonstrations, if somebody doesn't like it, you're falling asleep, it's too boring, somebody's leaving, I won't know. I'm just imagining all of you there and you're watching it. So you don't have a choice about that. The next one is, we have two more to go, a bunjin. This is a metal vase from Japan. And I have again pods of a tree. So I have these green pods. I've put in a crossbar so that it's easy for it to stand. I've done that earlier. So just to show the berries. Maybe you can move that a couple of inches back. So we have this line with all the berries. So you can see the tip of it. I'm going to move the thing back. Too many lines. I'm going to trim this line. Okay. we have to go back a little further. A little more. Okay. And you have to move the computer up. Yeah. Hold the base and turn up, Bindu. Yeah. A little more. Okay. With this, yes, I think that's a good view of the whole thing. And the line, let me put this. Some beautiful banana flower. So it is too tempting not to use that. I changed my entire plan of the Bunjin once I saw that. I think teeny bit shorter maybe. Okay. And then we have one more. Together. See, Ikebana International is about friendship through flowers. So we can say that these are the different chapters and different Ikebana practitioners of the world, two of them together, you know, friendly, different schools of Ikebana, everything being friendly. And again, we have pods in this too, the berries. These, as I was bringing them in, they fell down. So I'm going to just leave them here because it's pretty. The banana flower, then maybe one leaf with that. The banana leaf forms a beautiful backdrop, and the banana leaves are so pretty. No. And one more beautiful leaf out in the front. Can do some more trimming maybe. So that you see the banana leaf more clear, actually. We can go. That's better. And a bunch of pale green berries, because they show beautifully against the dark color of the vase. So I have them low down to do that. And then we have two materials, and usually in styles like the Bunjin and the Rimpa and the landscape, we kind of are particular about putting in odd numbers of materials. Like for the basic Hanamai, and you know, sometimes the Hanakanade, basic and advanced Hanesha, you don't have to worry about odd number of material. But for this, it's definitely nice to have an odd number of material. And for the third material, we right now have only two. So to use some of this, the nerium or the oleander. It's a pale pink and forms a lovely accompaniment to the banana flowers. So it's very malleable, you know, they bend and twist very nicely. A touch of light pink. I need that at an angle, not looking flat. Okay, that's at an angle. And we have two, I think, one more one, and the last touch. lower down. So this is the Bunjin arrangement, where it's very typical of the Ohara school, innovated by Mr. Ho Nohara, and they use it's based on the Chinese literati, and you have the vases also from there usually. And we have very natural garden material, never usually garden or cut flowers. Then you use, sometimes fruit. So if you see this banana flower, they're pretty little banana fruit also. This is an ornamental banana, but you can see the banana fruit also coming out of it. I think, and the last one I'll be doing for today is a landscape arrangement, you see, which is kind of the backbone of the Ohara school. It's kind of formed. It's one of the mainstays of the Ohara school. And so, I mean, there's so many beautiful ones, even the basic ones, the new Hana Kanade, which with headmaster Hiroki Ohara innovated. Then we have the one row forms, and we have the Rimpa, which is based on Rimpa painting, very beautiful. You know, I wanted to show you so many, but then we are always limited with time, and it's nice to make it brief. So this is a landscape. Okay. That's a heavy vase. And I carried it from Japan, and I was so scared to put in the luggage. I carried it in my hand. This was about 10 years ago. Now I definitely wouldn't have been able to do it, but somehow I managed at that point of time. So we'll get a good view of the landscape here. Maybe I'll move this a little more. So I'm going to use all foliage in this. So this is one of the dracaenas. I kind of pushed it in earlier because I have to hit it really hard on the ground. So this one branch I fixed into the pinholder earlier, because that requires a lot of noise and beating. So I'm using the dracaena. So it's just a natural landscape theme. There are different kinds. You have a realistic landscape. You have traditional landscapes. Traditional landscapes, you are fixed with the kind of material that you put in. So realistic landscape, you can view it in your mind. Imagine a scenery. It could be of Japan, it could be of India, it could be your surroundings, wherever you are. And you do it accordingly. And there's Mizumono, the waterside arrangements, which are also very beautiful. This is a typical landscape arrangement of a garden scene, which plants typically grow in the gardens in Hyderabad or in India. So it's going to be a lush green with not many flowers at all. So I'm using this dark, beautifully dark dracaena, because it's a nice contrast against the background. I'm using three of those stems. Just a clump of dracaena growing there. Then we have some of the other kind of dracaena. You have Song of India, Song of Jamaica, lots of varieties of dracaenas. Aurelia is of course very nice, because it's almost like they're like miniature trees. And I chose these with a thick stem, so they look like a wooded area. So this can come. Heavily wooded area there. I have a combination of shippos and pinholders in that, because the heavy ones is easier to fix into a shippo. Shippos are quite an indispensable part of some of the landscapes and other arrangements. I might do a little trip front later But let's see how. So I don't want any gaps in this area because it's a heavily wooded area. And anything to say? No? Okay. And so we have Aurelia, we have the Song of India. And then I'm putting in some Dracaena, different kind of Dracaena here. Give it a little bit of some high, low, then go up again high. So it gives you a little rhythm in that, what we have also. I have pin holders, many pin holders here and shippers. We never thought the day would come when we would be doing online demonstrations and working from home and so many things. It's just taking time, getting used to the berry factor here are the berries of the mehendi tree. So I have my friends to thank for these. Indu, Padma, Nirupa, who've given me this little material. Like I said, I won't have berries, so the mehendi berries. And it has this touch of pink which goes with this dark, magenta kind of color here also. The dark red. So berries there. Fresh cut it in Andy. A little more to me. You can see me cutting at an angle, which we always do. Some more of the mehendi berries. So if you have, we have one material, we have two, three, four, and because it's the rainy season, it's been raining yesterday and the day before, which is very good for me because of the material is staying really fresh. So I have this kind of a broom grass. So it kind of is like, see, it does remind you of a drizzle or a rain, isn't it? So I'm just going to put these in the middle. Just the feel of the rain. So just a light rain feel. A landscape doesn't really, I should do a little walk in the front. I'm trying not to. This one. This is out too far. I think it's better. So there's a little bit of cone shape. So just five material can be your entire landscape arrangement. Very, very natural garden scene. If you want to put in flower material, you can, but it's going to be something very subtle and very gentle. Like, for example, we have marigold. Marigold is so Indian, so much part of our culture and festivals and everything. So put a touch of marigold. And this is a rustic landscape, so there can be a little what is in your, you can imagine what's in your mind, a little scenery. I'm going to put marigold. Always very bright and very festive to have marigold. And a bit of the marigold leaves also, so it's like a natural part of it. All the marigold bushes growing in one area here. Yeah. Three of them. So just a touch of color would be very nice. Again, it's not imperative. You can do just greenery. The five precious ones. One low one, just peeping through. So just enough, or I have these rain lilies which come only in the rainy season. It is so tempting that when you have, if you have to limit yourself to a certain number, it gets very tempting. So we have to be prudent and be austere. See, these are so beautiful, they showed so well. So in an area there is rain, because there's rain here, okay? So in that area, I thought, let me put some rain lilies, just a couple of them. So my arms are reasonably long, so I can, okay. I'm just trying to make them. I can't see the people entering and exiting the chat, but I hope I can see. You can see the three there. Three of the lilies. And we can put in five. You can put in buds. See, there's more of these, or you can just leave it three also. There's no limit to how many you're putting in. If you're putting in them two more, I put them probably very low. So just about peeping through. So, you know, the excitement of wanting to show off many flowers and, you know, is there, but we don't have to yield to that. Just kind of peeping out through that. So this is the arrangement. I hope you can see it here. This is a landscape arrangement. You can, yeah, see it from a little closer, as long as the light doesn't come. Yeah, that's enough. Just bend the thing down, please. A little bit. Listen at the light. Yeah. So maybe you can see that better. So this is the landscape arrangement. And keep on moving that more further away. Very, very typical of the O'Hara school. And it shows just a landscape scenery, and you can do it as you wish. If you feel a little crowded here, of course, you can always trim away one or two of the leaves here, which I haven't done, some of the leaves, so you see it much more better and have a clearer area. So this is there with the rain and the rain leaves. So that concludes my demonstration. Thank you again so much, Delhi II, Nina, Shama, and the team for this opportunity. Thank you, Pranay Rupani, for hosting this so well and without a hitch. Thank you, members, Mrs. Suzuki, Okawara-san, all the senior members, Ikebana friends, and other friends who've been here with us and been part of the program. And if you have any questions, of course, you're welcome. And you can ask me, and you can maybe, Nina, maybe you can look through the chat box and let me know, and I'll answer them. Thank you very, very much.
A very big thank you. Rekha ji, a very, very big thank you to you for showing the most scintillating and captivating arrangements. I think everybody is in awe of all the material and the way you have done it. Thank you so very much. We'd also like to thank all the viewers for joining us. Mrs. Chikaze Suzuki, the President II from Tokyo, as well as members and II presidents and members were there from all over the world, from South Africa, from Dubai, from Singapore, from Sri Lanka, from all over India. Thank you so very much, all the viewers. One request, Rekha ji, we have, which everybody's been mentioning, is if you could slowly move the camera once around all the arrangements so we could, everybody could have one final last view of the arrangements.
I think I'll eventually put up a picture because the room is limited. It's in the house. So there, again, there's no backdrop. So maybe one or two of them I can. The others are in different backdrops, so it won't be, give a good idea. But I'll definitely take the pictures and send them to you, which you can send to your members and whoever's interested. So they'll be much clearer and better. Let me try to move it just to these two at least right now. Shall I?
Right, yes.
Okay, at least one to the circular one. But to move it closer, I've done largish heavy arrangements, so that's a little bit of an issue. Let me move that closer.
Rekha ji, everybody is very appreciative about the material and it's amazing.
Thank you.
Homegrown, yes.
Yeah, thank you so much. I was lucky. They all cooperated, the material also.
No, I think it's a learning experience for all viewers. And I'm sure everybody would be grabbing some of the other twig from their garden and doing that. So it's inspirational.
Thank you.
Yes.
A little bit, Emma. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you so very much.
Thank you, of course. Any other questions? You want me to look in the chat box? Otherwise, we are fine.
I've been going through the chat box, Rekha ji, but people are, I think, in awe of the arrangements.
That's it.
I'm glad. The combinations, they've loved the
I'm glad.
And the expanse of the arrangements. So thank you very much.
That means they've been awake. Thank you again.
Thank you, everybody, for your time.